So you're quick from the top. Your transition is no good. Your balance is all out of whack, and you cannot hit consistent golf shots. What is going on? Well, you've come to the right place, because today I'm going to show you how to smooth out your golf swing to improve your contact and definitely increase your distance. I'm PGA teaching professional Todd Cope, Director of Instruction for US Golf TV and the Sanford Power Golf Academy. And this is what I see every day at my driving range. And you tell me if this looks like yourself, okay? Because if you're watching this video, this might be what you look like. I get golfers, they come in, all right, they got a pretty good setup, pretty good grip, those types of stuff, and then they take the club back, I'm thinking, this is looking pretty good, and then boom, in the transition, it's fast and it's jerky, all right? Looks just like this, good setup, they take it back, and then they're out of balance and they're all over the place. What is going on? Well, here's what's happening. In the transition needs to be smooth and it needs to accelerate. So let me give you an example. Think of a car. All right, if you're watching this video, I'm assuming you can drive a car. All right, when you're driving a car and you need to merge into traffic, all right, you're on the on-ramp, the interstate's over here, you're on the on-ramp, you know instinctively that you've got to get your car going, all right, and you got to start transitioning so you can merge in with traffic. But when you do that, you want to have a natural acceleration. You don't get on the on-ramp and just floor it and get to 70 and then merge with traffic. Nor do you go super slow and then gas it to merge into traffic. Hopefully, if you're a good driver, which I'm assuming you are, is that you have a natural acceleration. The golf swing is the same way. When I'm swinging this golf club, I want to have a natural acceleration. So if I want to get this club swinging, let's say, 90 miles an hour, for sake of discussion. I'm not going to swing it 90 miles an hour right off the get-go. Okay? I'm also not going to swing it 10 miles an hour and then 90 miles an hour. Right? What I'm going to do is I'm going to build to that. So I'm going to get set up. Of course, it's at zero. And I'm going to build. I'm going to go from 30, 60. Okay? And I'm going to move up. So I'm 30, 60. Boom, 90. All right? Now, the question is, how do you do that? Well, let's talk about that. I got my live view set up right here. If you've watched any of my videos before, right here at US Golf TV, you know I love using live view, all right, because it provides live view, actually can show me what I'm doing. I use it with my students all the time. So I've got a red line right here as a reference. So I got a setup in here, and we're talking about this transition. What I typically see with golfers is they might have a good backswing, but if their transition is too quick, they move up and off this line early, okay? Some people call it early extending, but you can see them move up and away from that. Now what happens is that they can top the golf ball, all right, they hit behind it, they slice it, they got all types of stuff going on. So what should we be doing? Well, first thing is we've got to learn to load properly. We've got to naturally build that club head speed. Think of the car gradually building speed. How do we do that? Tip number one, here we go. Hip hinge. When you're set up here at address, you've got to have some bend in the hip. So let me pull my polo up here a little bit. Notice my belt. Now, for a good visual, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my club and I'm going to put it right along my belt. And this is why I love live view, okay? See the angle that my belt is on there. All right? A lot of you, when you're set up this way. See that? Okay, that's flat with the hips. You got to have some hip hinge. Now, why is hip hinge important? Hip hinge is important because that's what you turn into and you start to build up that energy. You're working from 0 to 30 to 60 to 90. So you're set in here, all right, got my hip hinge, and I start rotating and I maintain that hip hinge. See that? I got the hinge. There it is. I'm maintaining that as I'm turning into it. And that's the first thing that's going to help you improve your transition is properly loading the hips, all right? Probably never thought about that. So when you're set up at the golf course, get some hip hinge and kind of maintain it as you're going back. Now, let's talk about the transition, because this is where the magic happens. And I can tell you this, check out our channel. I mean, obviously you're here already, but subscribe to our channel, all right, because we got great information coming out all the time. I love hearing from you. And also check out our website at usgolftv.com. Different content over there. Written content, completely different, that can help you also. So this transition, let me show you this magic move, because this is a move that, quite honestly, not a lot of people have heard about, all right? But here, when you're sitting here, here's what I want you to feel, if you're quick from the top. You already loaded your hip, you know that, but in your transition, now you've got to load the legs. Okay? And in order to do that, watch my trail knee. I'm just going to flex it a little bit. See that? Boom. Little flex. Now, let's think about this for a second. I already gave you the example of the car merging, naturally building your speed. But let's think about other sports. Basketball, volleyball, any sport that involves jumping. When somebody wants to jump, what do? They flex, and then they extend. They don't just extend. You don't see a basketball shooter, certainly not anybody who's any good, stand there, knee knocked, catch a ball, and shoot it. Okay? The coach says, what do they tell you? Bend your knees, get set, get your hips set, get athletic, catch the ball, flex, jump, and shoot. It's the same way in the golf swing. Okay? This is why people struggle with their transition, is they don't correlate them to other sports. We've got the hips. We already talked about that. Load the hip. And now in the transition, load the leg. See that? Just a tiny, we're not talking about way down. I'm not talking about that. All right? Some of you might be thinking, we're not talking about that. We're talking about a mini flex of the trail knee. And then from there, rotate and hit. So let me go ahead and pop one off here. So here we go. Got my hip hinge at address. Maintain. Load the legs. Push up. Here we go. Now, see, that felt powerful. I don't know how it looked to you. It didn't feel quick. It didn't feel fast in transition. It felt like I was naturally accelerating. Now, watch this. Watch how this is different. Here's what I see on the driving range. This might be you, okay? Set up, flat hips, okay? Swing it up, okay? No extension, no power, thin, ugly shot, out of balance. So when we head to the golf course, we're going to load the hip, we're going to load the knee. So here we go, we're set in there, okay? We got the car, we're on the on-ramp, right? We're going to naturally start building speed, we're going to accelerate. Here we go, hip hinge to start. That means that we got our foot on the gas pedal. We start to load that gas pedal. We're going to keep loading that gas pedal, and then we're going to merge into traffic. Here we go. Ready? Oh, yeah. That felt powerful and nice and rhythmic. So transition, if you're quick from the top, if you're doing all types of things, think about how you're loading. Think about the car. Think about the analogy. Think about other sports that you play. If you do those types of things, you're going to definitely start hitting better golf shots.